Hey guys, welcome to episode 5 in our series. This one's gonna be something different than what we've done in the past. I'm actually on my way to a local university right now where we're hosting a catfishing event. And the whole point of the event is just to get, you know, America's youth out there and fishing. We're gonna do something different because we're gonna be doing primarily shore fishing. Afterwards, when all the students go back to their dorms, I still have the boat in tow. We'll take the boat out and hopefully catch some more fish.
There's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. Hey, brother, do you still believe in one another? Hey, sister, do you still believe in love? I wonder.
Guys, we're back at it again in Elgin, Illinois. We're gonna do an event here a couple days long. We're gonna be out here for about 2 days, two nights. Well, one night, 2 days. Got the tent set up, as luck would have it. We're setting the tent up and the storm came in. We got soaked, everything's soaked, the gator soaked, everything's wet now. But we fish this area quite often with the boat. We do fish on the bank as well. Obviously, that's where we're at today. So we're gonna fish all day today, all night tonight, all day tomorrow, and all night tomorrow night. And we'll keep you posted. It'll be about a 48-hour segment. That's not how long the video is gonna be, but we're hoping to catch a big flathead in here. This is about a 7-foot hole. If I were to walk out here another 3 or 4 feet, I'd be 3 feet in the water already. A lot of boats come up and down this area. This is an excellent spot for our bait fish. We do catch a lot of bait fish here, but we're gonna go cut bait during the day, and we're gonna go live at night. We brought the boat as well. So tonight we might launch a boat on the other side and take that up north to one of our other holes, a turtle spot. And we'll keep you guys posted as the day progresses. What if I'm far from home? Oh, brother, I will hear you call. All right, guys, we're gonna do a bait reveal for you all. We caught a 44-pound catfish just north of here about 2 months ago, 2.5 months ago. And we caught him on cut bait at 2 a.m. Was not a live bluegill. This is what we use for bait. Lake trout steaks. We bought it at Butera. It's $1.53 for these cuts. We got 3 of these for this 48-hour segment. Same principle. You just apply it like you would on a nice size circle hook. So I'm actually going to use this whole cut bait, this whole piece of cut bait. And this stuff stinks. And that's what does it for these flatheads. Is something that stinks. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use a circle hook about that big. Go right through one side and out through the other end. Now this stuff's real tough, this skin. It ensures that this stays on the hook for a nice long time. It stinks so bad. I've never eaten this from this store. We only use it for bait, but I'm sure it's very edible. And we're gonna pitch this out there into the deep. Again, we're fishing daytime today, so we wanna go as deep as we can. And then we're gonna switch tactics up tonight. We're gonna go nice and shallow once darkness falls tonight. So rip this guy out there.
Hey, sister, do you still believe in love? I wonder. Oh, if the sky comes falling down for you.
All right, guys, this is one of our standard rigs right here. This is an old catfishing pole that I've had for probably about 15 years. We've got a 4-ounce lead weight on this because the current's pretty strong out here, and we're gonna go up current with this particular rod. So the heavier up current we go, the heavier our weight is, so we don't get tangled up in the other lines. Down to a bead. This bead protects this knot right here, and it protects this knot from going into that hole on your weight. So the bead is pretty essential. I like pink because it's our favorite color. Down to about a 15-inch leader on this is 50-pound braid. And this is 50-pound mono. We're using that lake trout I was telling you about. Now, just to show you why this stuff is so effective, look at how oily and greasy this stuff is. As I'll put it in the water here, it looks like I'm dropping motor oil into the water. That's why this stuff is so effective. I'll pull it out. You can see all those specks of what grease and oil and that fishy aroma. And this stuff stinks. Definitely not where I wanted to cast, so I'm gonna pull that one out and recast.
Hey,
keep reeling?
Nope, you're good. Good job.
Oh, gosh.
All right, you want to grab the pole too.
Okay. Oh, hi.
Here,
I'm
hold
sorry.
This in your left hand.
I'm sorry. Can you take it quick?
You're fine. Look at us. You're fine. Look at us.
The extravaganza finally came to a slowdown. All the people started to leave, and we were teaching, you know, the people what to do and how we set up our rigs and how we catch these fish in this river. So we couldn't really get a lot of footage for you guys, you know, just in between Jake and I showing people how to tie knots and things like that. We had a great time though. A couple of fish, a couple of the poles went off, and hopefully now that the kids essentially are packed away for the night, we're gonna stay here. We're actually gonna spend the night out here and keep fishing, and hopefully have some good footage for you guys.
What's up, guys? Well, I was sleeping and something happened. Jake got slammed on this pole right here. Did you say it was cup bait or what was this?
It was live bait.
Live bait.
Live bait.
Piece of live bait. Probably a bluegill or something. Not a bad little channel. Very nice.
Open up, buddy. It's time to let go.
Time to let go.
Yeah.
Finally get to test out our new fish weigher.
Yeah.
Nice channel. Funny that the channels are biting on live bait. Haven't caught a flathead tonight yet. This is the second channel of this 48-hour fishing extravaganza. Like I said, I was on my cot sleeping while he gets that hook out. I'll show you my little setup here. This is my cot. There's my hair net. Keeps the mosquitoes out. There's my flannel serving as a pillow. Did you get him out? All right, we'll throw him on the scale for you guys and let you know how much he weighs. All right, so we got our new fish weigher here. Let's, all right, zeroed out. Do your thing down there. All right, let's see where he's at. Oh, all right, buddy. 5.23.
So it's 5 pounder. Not bad.
5 pounder.
Not bad for short fishing.
Yeah, no kidding. Normally we got our game's pretty good on the boat. We haven't short fished in a while. But this new, how much did you pay for this thing?
$12 on Amazon.
$12 on Amazon. Works pretty good. Came with batteries, right?
Yep.
Comes with a little hook there, and then we use our Rapala, whatever you call that thing, gaffing tool or clipper, whatever. Nice fish. A little dark. He's all covered in sand. That's just sand. We're on a
sand
island here. He's going to rinse them off for you guys. Nice little 5 pounder. Real nice looking fish. Very nice looking fish. Got a belly on them again. These fish are eating real good tonight. Maybe that's why they haven't been biting as good, because they've been getting food somewhere else. We'll keep you guys posted.
Real nice hit just now. Look at the thumb on this pole. Ooh.
Oh, he's right there.
This is a bluegill we had on here. Nice.
Ooh, that is a very nice one.
Can you lip him?
I'll have to put the camera down.
Go for it.
All right. Ooh, that is a nice fish. Yeah, let's work that hook out.
Oh, it's a tiny little hook on there.
Alrighty.
I'm gonna go with maybe 15, 16 pounds.
Oh, shit.
Biting hard?
Oh, he's got some kick to him. All right, so we got him on the scale here. And that is 15.7-ish, so almost a 16 pounder. You gonna hold him up for the camera for us?
Real nice fish.
Yep.
Definitely a fatty. The biggest one of the night so far. 15.8, right around there. Hit hard, hit real hard, hit real fast. And he still got some fight left in him.
Oh yeah, it's a big guy.
He's eating good.
What's going on, guys? Unfortunately, our 2-day or 3-day fishing extravaganza got rained out. We've had sporadic storms throughout the day, make it real difficult to, one, keep people interested in the event. We had a lot of people come out last night, and this morning we decided to pack up shop and get going. So we're not gonna complete our 2-day event, but next week we have something pretty exciting for you guys. we're going to review the Arctic 65 cooler. If you guys don't know about the company Arctic, they're very, very comparable to Yeti. Check out their website, arcticcoolers.com. My opinion is that they'll probably outperform the Yeti. I have a Yeti, but we'll review it. We're taking it to Mississippi with us. Correction, we're taking it to the Mississippi River with us in Savannah, Illinois. And our intention is to have one bag of ice and see how the cooler does with just one bag of ice for the whole weekend that we're down in Savannah. So stay tuned for that. Arctic cooler review. This is 65 tan edition. It should be in Monday. We've waited about 3 months to get it. Their wait is extremely long, but I hope that means the cooler is exceptionally good.